Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hi, my name is Van Linden Cheney, and I would like to welcome you back to the second annual mic conference. And, again, I'm Van Linden Cheney, and for the second year in a row, I am back to kick us off. We want to thank you all for being here today, and many of you for the second time. It means a lot to us that you are continuing to show up as we bring together those who are brand new to cybersecurity with those who are already a part of the cybersecurity profession, all with the goal of opening doors to increase the participation of the underrepresented groups in cybersecurity. The MIC community represents some of the brightest minds in the profession, and it is my mom's goal to get you there faster and prepare each of you to be the next generation of cybersecurity leaders. We want to thank our platinum sponsors, Bloomberg and MassMutual, our gold sponsor, MIC Talent Solutions, our silver sponsor, Adobe, our conference app sponsor, Google, our lanyard sponsor, Discernible, our Wi-Fi sponsor, ISC Squared, and I would also like to thank Discernible, Carnegie Mellon University, and Tylesia Shields as benefactor scholarship sponsors. And for the second year in a row, a special thank you to our media sponsor, Security Magazine. Since last year, we have watched our community continue to grow and are very proud of the progress we are making. Throughout the next 3 days, we will learn more about our growing community and what is on the horizon. But now, let's turn our attention to an animated short prepared by my sister. Last year, her characters were stuck into the conference without paying. Let's see what they're up to this year.
March 4th, 2024, 10:30 p.m.
Come in.
Hey, CJ. What are you doing?
Hey, Liam. I'm looking into Mike's 2024 conference schedule.
Oh, really? You want to go there again this year?
Yes. I loved being there last year. It was a joy seeing Miss Cheney on stage, talking passionately about cybersecurity. She's very inspirational, and I've been following her teachings ever since.
I thought it was really cool, too. I also liked how I got to dress nicely, even if no one else was.
Would you dress up again if we went back this year?
Of course. I'll be able to pay, too, because I have a job.
Are you sure you'll be able to pay?
100%. How much does getting in cost?
$179 per person to get in?
Excuse me? What? So if you, me, and the twins go, that would be...
$716. Plus, we probably have to pay for last year, too, so that would be $1,432 total to get in.
Oh my lord. I don't get paid enough for that.
How much do you have in your savings?
Like 600, I think.
Well, maybe if you didn't go to the mall every month.
Okay, listen. It's not like I go to Gucci every day or something.
All right, then. Well, Miss Cheney has this apprenticeship program that's relatively new. I don't know much about it right now, but I'm asking Mom if I could join soon. It seems alluring.
That should help you out, CJ. All right, I'm going to bed. Good night.
Night. Love you.
I love you too.
What are we going to do?
A few weeks later.
Okay, just a few days before our second MIC conference. How are we feeling?
I don't know whether to laugh or cry.
What do you mean?
Well, on one hand, it was super boring and I fell asleep halfway through. But on the other hand, I got to skip school and clown on Liam for overdressing.
All right, bro. I hope you know I'm doing it again this year, so I better not hear a word out of you.
Whatever you say, fancy pants.
Good. So anyways, let's talk about getting in this year. I talked to CJ a few weeks ago and found out that it cost $716 for all of us to get in.
Bro, what? $1,432. We still have to pay for last year, too.
Oh my gosh.
So, how do we plan on getting in this year? I suggest cutting the room open.
Jane, no, that's ridiculous. I say we go through the chimney.
Psh, girl, that's not much better.
Okay, so how about we not go on the roof at all? I'm sure we can come up with something less risky.
Oh, I have an idea. We can wear full face masks.
Huh? You and I already wear face coverings, CJ.
I think she means masks, like the ones I have in my theater class. In which case, I think that's a great idea.
Oh, I can paint the masks!
How, though? You only got a few days.
Oh, trust me. I'll finish it in no time.
Alrighty then. You sure this is gonna work?
Yep. We should be fine.
What if there will be security guards at the front or something?
Well, I can act like an adult bringing in their kids or something like that. That get us through.
Fine by me.
But if there are guards there, what will happen if they still won't let us through?
Heh. Then I'll happily knock their freaking lights out.
Jaden, please don't.
Duly noted. But I'm sure that won't be necessary. It's not like we're wanted by the police or something.
Right, imagine that.
3 days later. Man, it feels nice to be back here again.
Yeah, I agree. I'm kind of cold though.
Guys?
What's wrong, CJ?
We've got warrants for our arrest.
Huh?
Are you serious? Oh my gosh!
Those are fake, right? I mean, look at them. It looks like someone drew them from here. They are real.
I don't want to go to jail.
We're not going to jail, CJ. I'll make sure of it.
Well, that line is moving quickly, so if we want to go in, we better do it now.
Okay, we can do this, guys. Let's blend in with the line.
Oh, we can distract everyone by throwing rocks against a tree!
That's a stupid idea, Jade. It doesn't even make any sense.
Well, yes, but we don't have a lot of choices.
That's probably going to be one of our best case scenarios, considering we're wanted. Hey, we're going to be okay.
There's a fight going on.
Wait, really?
Oh my gosh!
But why?
Beats me. But let's run inside.
Wait, what? What?
Ow, ow, ow!
Hey, wait up!
What the heck were you thinking? That was very dangerous and very stupid. We could have gotten tackled.
We didn't have many options. At least things can't get much worse from here.
Ouch!
Oh, crap. Sorry, Jade.
Oh, it's okay. I bet you didn't leave a bruise.
Whew, I hope I didn't.
Thank you.
all just stay here for the entire presentation.
Yeah, good idea. I just hope we don't get caught.
Mary is the real deal. She shows up for us again and again, and she has worn many hats with us. Sometimes she's a fairy godmother. Sometimes she's a little bit of a therapist. Sometimes she, you know, gives that tough love and, you know, doesn't accept any guff from us. We really do have to be on our game, but by her own example, she shows us the way. And without her, the industry would really have a serious gap, a loss, because there's nobody who's doing what she's doing for us the way she's doing it. And we're so privileged to know her and to have been a part of the program and the vision that she has in store for all of us, especially in this community. Love me when you don't love yourself. Let's heal the world. One beautiful action at a time. This is real love. With your soul, with your intuition. This is real. Renaissance, the revolution. Pick me up even if I fall. Let love heal us all. Us all. Don't make me get up out my seat. Don't make me get up out my seat.
Sorry. Hello, everybody. I told Sandy I changed my song, you know, but it always has to be a Beyonce song, right? Right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the second annual Minorities in Cybersecurity Conference. I am so excited to be here with you guys. Hopefully you guys are too. I entitled this presentation, it takes my best friend who's back there to talk about me as it relates to this topic, which is There's Something About Mary. It is a joke, but it is, you know the movie. Anytime something happens that is positive, I just always say There's Something About Mary, right? And when they ask, I'm like, go watch the movie. Okay, I know I'm talking to some young folks. Do y'all remember the movie? Okay. I have to check. So let's talk about Mary. Look at that. Look at the two little ones right there. This is my family, as part of my family. The beautiful woman there with the gray hair is my mom. She's in the audience today. And the woman in the middle is my grandma, right? So like you guys, I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth. You know, my mom, as beautiful as she is, she had me when she was 18 years old. So, and my dad wasn't in my life, and so it became a labor of love with extended family like many of you, right? And grandma was that force. And she was in there, and she was doing all that she could. She had 9 kids, and as a single mom of 9, right? And one thing I can say that I did get from her was this attitude of, I'll just do it myself. You know, that's always been the sentiment whenever something happens. It's, I'll just do it myself. And I get that from my grandmother. But I would say the thing that I got from my mother was this sense of education and lifelong learning. When I was in the 11th grade, my dearest mother took a role at in the facilities at Xavier University. And you know, what that meant was Mary graduated without debt because 80% of my tuition was paid. I got a scholarship, but she was cleaning rooms. Ultimately, cleaning rooms for others got me through through a college degree. So instead of taking that partial D1 scholarship to play basketball, I went to Xavier to focus on my education. And that's something that no one could ever take away from you, is that lifelong learning. And you guys need to understand that that is important. And to become a subject matter expert. Now, I've been in this space for over 30 plus years. I was, for those that don't know, I'm former FBI. All the things that I've done in my career just came from a curiosity and remaining curious about the things that were around me. So cybersecurity I'm an IT geek, right? That's what I went to school for. And then I went to law school and I graduated number two in my class. Then, I went into corporate America. Went through the FBI. Now, some of y'all met Special Agent Cheney yesterday, right? Those of you who were not at the shooting event yesterday, let's just say I surprised some people. It's one thing to say you know how to shoot. It's another thing to have the shotgun in your hand in dead center five times. Then it becomes, oh, crap, she. So we did have a lot of fun. But, FBI, Special Agent Cheney, and then coming out being an executive in corporate America, or entrepreneur. You guys know Mike will be 5 years this year, and we will continue to move forward. But for you guys in your career, when you're asking yourself what it is, dig in deep to your career and become a subject matter expert, and be a people leader. Honestly, being a people leader will challenge you like nothing else, and that's for your growth. Because it's preparing you. Every step of the way, everything that you do is preparing you for that next step. And there's nothing like leading people to humble you and get you to the point where you're like, this is crazy, but you're growing, right? And then never be deterred. Never let anybody stop you from where you want to go, right? And sometimes we just have to embrace the fact that we are the only ones in the room. I mean, we are collectively are diverse here, but we go outside to the broader community, we may be the only ones. And that's fine. You guys have to embrace that and live in it and step in it, because you are preparing the room for someone else, right? Focus. Now, follow one course until successful. And this is what I talk to my apprentices about. I say, what in the world do y'all want to do? Miss Mary, I want to be a pen tester. I said, okay, do you know what information security is? And they're like, information security? Okay. You know what information assurance is? Okay. Do you know the foundational principles of what cybersecurity is? I just want to be a pen tester. Okay, well, you can't penetrate a network if you don't know how to defend a network, because you're working against other people who are defending, so you need to know their tools, techniques, and practices that they use, TTPs. I'm gonna drop a little geeky stuff on y'all today. You have to know their TTPs in order to, thwart them, But it's what do you want to do and why are you doing it, right? Folks are out here chasing certifications. My team will tell you that I'm not the biggest person. Don't stop laughing. I'm not the biggest person when it comes to certifications, because it's chasing. You go down a path and you're chasing that path. But what if the company you're interviewing for, you're doing AWS and they're Google or Azure? And now all the skills that you've obtained, you're now going to be typecast, so to speak, as an AWS expert, and that limits your options, right? So why are you doing what you're doing, and are you chasing it, or are you letting it come to me, come to you? Now, I understand they're chasing. I chased that CISO role for a while, you know, in my book. I chased it for a while. I chased it, but I was never successful, right? I never really broke into that C-level information security officer role, but I never really felt comfortable to me chasing. It still doesn't. And I was chasing, and then it dawned on me. I said, well, how many people can I really help as one CISO? How about I create an organization where I work with CISOs to place more of you, as opposed to just one person making a difference? One person making a difference inside a corporation is great. One person making a difference with all the corporations, it's awesome, right? And you know, Mike was founded on that thought process to be able to help the broader community, because it just never felt right. This feels right to me, right? Every time I talk to each one of you, each and every last one of you, every time I talk to the apprentices, you know, they say, Mary, thank you, this is needed, right? So it's important. So focus on what you want. Open doors for others. Now, you guys seen this from on the website, I think. There's a huge difference between showing you the table behind the glass and asking you to be my plus one because you deserve a seat. All right, so listen, we're gonna get into some real talk now, okay? What are you willing to give up? You're gonna have to give up something. I'm here to tell you that traveling up the corporate ladder is a very challenging thing, right? And you have to understand that there are certain things that you're gonna have to give up, right? And it's not just the cybersecurity ladder that we're talking about. It's to become a subject matter expert. There's always a price. You guys know I tell stories. So I paid almost $10,000 to get in a room once, right? In this particular room, it was in Santiago, Chile. So you know there's travel money. Now nothing was paid. it came out of my pocket. And go down there. There are women in this room. It wasn't a cybersecurity room. It was every amazing woman across the face of this country room, right? And in that room were Supreme Court justices. In that room were people that had meetings with the freaking Pope. But also in this room, there was a woman that said to another African-American female colleague of mine, oh, you're a successful N-word, aren't you? Now, Special Agent Cheney didn't hear that. I didn't hear it, but it was expressed. And so it stopped me dead in my tracks, because I paid $10,000 to be in this room, right? I can go out here on the corner in Texas and be called the N-word for free. So why am I here, right? You have these doors that you go in and you pay that price. But again, we're here to teach you how to deal with that, because you're going to have to, and you can't be deterred. There's gonna be something that stops you in your tracks, and you cannot be deterred. You just be like, okay, yeah. For that particular, I walked out of that room. But again, this conference is a mirror of the rooms that I've been in, right? From the golf, Top Golf on Sunday, and then the shooting range yesterday. These are all spaces that I've been in with people that don't look like me, right? The game night, the talent show, all of that. These are rooms that I've been in over the course of my career that I'm trying to prepare you to be in yourselves, right? Because they exist. Now, whether you know they exist or not, that's a question that only you know the answer to. Are you willing to walk in those rooms? You should be, right? And that's what we're doing. We're preparing you, each and every last one of you, to take your seat at the table. Because I'm going to open doors. I'm going to kick them. I'm going to, you know, shoot them down. I'm going to pick the lock and go through the back door to try to get you in there. But I'm also preparing you to be there in that room, to hold your own space within that room. Now, I don't think Dee is here, but me and her have this love of Jay-Z. And that's one of my favorite quotes from 444. All right, y'all think it's bougie, but it's fine. I'm trying to give you $1 million worth of gain for $179. he said $9.99 for those of you. But okay, so let's have a conversation. Let's have a real talk again about this $179. Now, I told my team I was gonna fuss at y'all today. And y'all knew it was coming. So it's just a matter of where along the speech am I gonna fuss. Now, I remember back when I was growing up, $100 was a lot of money, right? $100 was a lot of money. Y'all wanna know how much Miss Mary is spending on food for this conference, just for breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks? Huh? You don't wanna know? I'm gonna tell you the $179 don't cover. Y'all want me to tell y'all the truth? Real talk? $70,000 for food. And then I have folks want, oh, well, can I get a free ticket? Are you eating? And I'm also fussing at y'all about this last minute stuff. Now, I know, I warned the guys that I was gonna talk about them. Yeah, go ahead, put your head down. I see you over there in the corner. I told them when I got to this part of the speech that I was directly speaking to them as they come to me Sunday afternoon wanting to get in on Top Golf. And you know he lucky I didn't see that email until after the shooting range event that you was trying to get to the shooting range too. Now, when there's deadlines, this is a whole production, right? And we have to order food, we have to, you know, do all the things. Right? And the whole last minute thing, y'all killing us. We order t-shirts, and we got sizes, for those of you who know me personally, y'all know I'm anal. Y'all know that? Detail oriented is what I am. So it throws me every time somebody, oh, well, can I get in here? I'm like, come on, man. We've been doing this for 6 months. We've been registering for 6 months. So, but understand that doors have other doors behind them. And if you fail to walk in a door, you'll never see the other door, right? So you can't shy away from walking into uncomfortable spaces. Those spaces could teach you something and can get you in front of someone else, right? And you will always have distractions and distractors. The closer you get to what you want, things will start to pop up. And, you know, my life is no different. Things pop up. And it's like, oh, well, do I spend time with this? Do I give this the energy? Or do I stay on course? That's important. It's important to stay on course because there are always going to be distractions. And there are always going to be people that want to, you know, throw something at you that will distract you from your course of action. But you have to remain fast. The warning there, can't take everybody with you. That's you know, as the superhero that I think I am, that throws me because I want to save everybody. But some people, okay, we get the little J. Cole here, don't save them because they don't want to be saved. There are some people that you just can't save. And you have to understand that that's your best friend, but he or she can't go with you in this room. And that it is what it is. That's a hard pill to swallow, but I need you guys to understand that as well. Now, this is Oprah. This is one of my favorite quotes as well. Follow your passion, do what you love, and the money will follow. Most people don't believe it, but it's true. You have to be able to follow something. Follow your passion. You guys know, I feel like this is my purpose. My purpose is to be here to assist you to get to where you want to go. That's my purpose. I'm very passionate about the cybersecurity profession. I have little tolerance for silliness in corporate America. But I'm gonna get y'all there. I don't have to be there no more. I'm old. I can get y'all there. I can get y'all and I get y'all to learn. But there's a lot of silliness that goes on and unnecessary that can potentially get in between you and your love, right? I know cybersecurity, privacy, risk management, up, down, and around. But then you'll have people, oh, well, do you know how to do this? I said, I'm not in a position in my career that I feel like I have to prove my knowledge. The resume speaks for itself, right? And then you got my grandma. I'll do it myself. I'll just do it myself. So this is what we have, right? This is the impact. You guys know I'm big on metrics, right? And what we're doing. And just since 2022, we have a small investment. So I had an idea. Okay, I'm going to take individuals that are in corporate America and I'm going to teach them how to be leaders, how to be people leaders. It's the Mike Lead Communicators course, right? That's the communicators course. That was the first course. It was January of 2022, right? And all it was a small investment, a little bit of investment by Mr. Ossie Monroe, who can't be here. He's down on the beach somewhere. A $50,000 investment. And what happened then? That little bit of money, last year you guys saw me on the stage, I was talking about the apprenticeship program, right? I begged Ossie, I begged Damon, and I begged Aisha. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Ossie's not here. Thank you. I begged. I need a letter. And we got our Department of Labor Certified Apprenticeship Program April 27th last year. And we have our first cohort of apprentices that are going through. And they started in September. We already have 3 placements. Bloomberg took 2, right? So essentially what we're trying to do is work with organizations that want to hire our talent. Now, Damon has gotten over on me twice. He's hired 2 people out of the Mike Lead courses, and I ain't seen a dime of that money. No finder's fee, nothing. Oh, come on, Damon. But our sponsors do hire our talent, and that's the point. So, okay, so the Mike team, stand up. Anybody that's on my direct team, stand up. Yep, Mike talent, Mike, yep. All right. Mike Lead graduates, stand up. If you're a graduate of any Mike Lead program, stand up. All right, let's see what we got. Any Mike Talent apprentices in the room, please stand up. Mike Lead trainers? Where did Sandy disappear to?
She just left.
All right. At least I do believe I said graduates. Thank you. Mike, board of directors members, stand up. All right, so take a look around you. The community is growing. The community is building. Everybody needs deserves a round of applause for being here. Oh, you in the current communicators course. Okay, so I didn't specify current. Oh, okay, that's how you got out. I'm looking at you like, why aren't you standing? Oh my goodness. But all this to be said is the community is working. We're training each other to be the next generation. And that community exists without me. So is there something about Mary? Who knows? I lead it, right? But we have 86 cybersecurity analysts in training. We've developed over 125 underrepresented individuals. We're in 8 countries, 29 states and the District of Columbia in the United States. 48 graduates, 24 job opportunities, right? And 3 apprentice placements. 4 executive level promotions. One of my favorite stats. Because executive level promotions mean they are now hiring managers, which mean they can hire other people. Oftentimes, we don't necessarily get that opportunity. Budget seems to lose us. and hiring, the decision making tends to escape. But we definitely want to key in on those executive level promotions, because then we get more people in the door. And share your knowledge. Now, I didn't say my mentors. If you are not a mentor right now in minorities in cybersecurity, I'm gonna need y'all to go ahead and sign up. We need about 9 more people for our apprentices. So I'm pretty sure we can find 9 more professionals in this room that can spend an hour a month with our apprentices just to mentor them. Because I did not say the folks from the lead graduate program that interviewed the apprentices know what I'm talking about when I say this, because our lead graduates actually interviewed the apprentices. I don't need to do everything. I'm busy enough. So they did that. They came together. Miss Mary, I got you. I'll definitely do these interviews for you, right? That's how the community is supposed to work. They need help, these apprentices. I need you. They're out there thinking that they're gonna make $200,000 to do absolutely nothing. So I need y'all to help them out. I'm gonna need y'all to help them out. If you know people, I'm serious. They do. And everything is new to them. So, you know, they have all the answers and not enough questions, which is what they should have. All right. And this is another thing that I like to say. There's only one person standing between you and your dreams. I couldn't figure out where I got that from, but it's something that I used to put in my signature line. So get out of your own way, right? The thought process is, at this point in time, we're all here to build and make connections, to build our brand. Shout out to Tia. To build our brand and to be here in the room, to prepare everyone in this room to be the next generation of cybersecurity professionals. Because when we go, we go. Me and Ms. Vita, we old, you know. We get tired. I don't know where Miss Renee upstairs running, having meetings. But there's a group of us that just want to give y'all the knowledge and say, go with it. Because we didn't have that when we were struggling in our careers and we had to latch on to each other. And girl, how did you do this? Girl, what did you do with that? Those are the types of things we had to do. But this community is meant to give you a place to go. And the only thing that's stopping you from being successful is your ability to be vulnerable and tell somebody you need help. Because we're here, we're going nowhere. The second year in a row, we got it, right? All right, we're only gonna keep growing and we're only gonna keep sharing. But you have to do that work too. So when they say there's something about Mary, I don't believe it. I just believe that I'm dug in and I'm not gonna take no for an answer. Stubborn, my mother would probably say. But I'm not, and I'm here for you guys. So thank you very much for listening. I want you guys to enjoy the second annual conference. Mr. Easley wants us all to get prepared to take our photo. Please, 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 workshop. We have a financial services workshop that many of you need to attend, because I'm just saying, they're gonna be doing a breakout after we take our picture. But come on, everybody up, let's go.